In this video, we need to develop some machinery. We're going to be solving the partial differential equations using the finite difference method. In the finite difference method, you have to convert the derivatives in the differential equation into differences of the values of the function at two points. So the main derivative that we'll use is called the central difference approximation. In one dimension, I can show it to you. If we have three grid points, so this is x, this is x plus h, and this is x minus h. If we want to compute the derivative of a function in the x direction, we want the derivative at x, or maybe we want the second derivative at x. We want to develop a difference formula between the value of the function at these three points that will result in an approximation to the derivative of the function at x. Okay? We'll be using these central difference approximations then to convert our continuous partial differential equations into a discrete form of the equation that has differences between the values on different grid points. So how do we come up with these formulas? Well, we can use Taylor series. So here I'm just going to do the one-dimensional problem. So y then will be a function of x. And we can Taylor series the value of y at these two points on both sides of x. So if we do that, the Taylor series of y of x plus h is given by y of x plus h times y prime of x plus h squared over 2 y double prime of x plus h cubed over 6 y triple prime of x. And let me carry one more term. So it's plus h to the fourth over 4 factorial, which will be 24 times the fourth derivative of x. And then there are infinite terms in the series, but we'll truncate it there. You see we have the derivative here, and that's what we'll be looking for. To get this derivative, we can Taylor series expand at x minus h. So the only difference here is h goes to minus h. So we'll have y of x minus h, y prime of x, minus h squared is plus h squared over 2 y double prime of x, minus h cubed is minus h cubed over 6 y triple prime of x, and minus h to the fourth is plus h to the fourth over 24, the fourth derivative. Okay? Our goal now, we can try and find y prime. To get y prime, we can subtract the second equation from the first equation, right? If we subtract them, then we get y of x plus h minus y of x minus h. Y minus y cancels. H minus h becomes 2h y prime of x. The h squared terms cancel. The h2 cubed terms becomes plus 2h cubed over 6 y triple prime of x. And the y h to the fourth term cancels. And then we can solve this then for y prime. So this equation will give us y prime of x is equal to y of x plus h minus y of x minus h divided by 2h. And the error here, I'll write as big O dividing by h, so big O of h squared, okay? This is the formula then to compute the derivative of y at x. We difference y at x plus h minus y of x minus h divide by 2h, and we get an error term that's order h squared. Okay. We'll also need the second derivative. So how do we get the second derivative from these two formulas? Well, if we add them, the first derivative will cancel. So we can try adding them. We have y of x plus h plus y of x minus h. If we add them, we get 2y of x. And then the first derivative cancels. And we get plus h squared over h squared times y double prime of x. And then the y cubed cancels, and the y fourths add. So we have plus h to the fourth, or the h to the fourths add, over 12 y fourth derivative of x. Okay? We're looking for the second derivative. So here we get the second derivative. Let me write it here. We get y double prime of x then is equal to y of x plus h minus 2 y of x plus y of x minus h divided by h squared. And the error term here then is, since we divide it through by h squared, is h fourth over h squared is big O of h squared. Okay? So what have we done? I'm trying to construct central difference approximations for the first derivative and for the second derivative. So we have these 3 points, x, x plus h, x minus h. We Taylor series expand y at x plus h around x and x minus h around x. And by manipulating the Taylor series expansions then, we can get a formula for the derivative of y in terms of its values at x plus h and x minus h. This is called a central difference approximation because x is in the center of these 3 points. Similarly, we can manipulate these equations, these Taylor series expansions, and get a formula for the second derivative of y at this middle point. That will be y of x plus h minus 2 times y of x plus y of x minus h here divided by h squared. And again, the error term is also proportional to h squared. It's very nice to have formula where the error goes as h squared rather than h. It means that you can choose a larger distance between points to have the same level of accuracy. Okay, part of the machinery that we'll need to convert partial differential equations into algebraic equations. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.